What has happened over the last 20 or 30 years is food supply systems have become much more complicated, global sourcing of materials, and that has a lot of positives with it. But the threat that comes with that is the complexity, the ability to allow criminals to penetrate food supply systems.
Wherever there's a premium associated with a product, the risk for food fraud increases. Imported beef from South America is significantly cheaper than European beef, but visually, two steaks look indistinguishable. Paper traceability gives you a paper trail of where something's come from or how it was produced, but no link back to the product. Isotope testing links the product to the paper.
I describe isotope testing as one of the techniques in the armory of those people who are trying to authenticate the food supply systems.
There are key areas you can use stable isotope ratio analysis. One is for detecting adulteration, so adulteration with sugars in fruit juices or honey. And the second is for validation of origin. If it's Italian olive oil, was it produced in Italy?
So Grana Padano came to us to see if isotopic analysis can be used to discriminate the PDO cheeses from the non-PDO cheeses. We compare the data of the sample with the data of the database. And once we are both confident that the sample is adulterated, the consortium, on the basis also of other analysis, suspends the PDO license for 6 months and ask for a fine.
From a legal perspective, we can see isotope testing used in support of enforcement action to cross-validate with paper traceability, audits, and other intelligence that's come in to support prosecutions.
SGF is an industrial association. We have been for more than 40 years controlling the safety, the quality, the authenticity, and sustainability of the fruit juices. Adulterations can increase tremendously the profits for non-ethical companies. We can detect and confirm the addition of external sugar, acids and water, which is very cheap materials to adulterate. Because we are using the stable isotopic analysis, we know that when we prosecute, we are quite confident that we will win the case.
Going forwards, I think you'll see much wider use of stable isotope testing as a validation that paper traceability is good, that supply chain integrity is solid. It will also help pinpoint the areas where it's not, so we can work on those and improve those.
Whenever the consumer goes into a shop, big or small, whatever they buy should be safe, high quality, and authentic.
It's the responsibility of every person and business in the food supply chain to take responsibility for the integrity of the foods that they're handling. And part of that will be very much driven by isotope testing.